Once we have identified independently testable features, the next step is to identify the relevant inputs for each one of these features. And there are many ways to do that. So what we're gonna do instead of looking at them all is that we're just gonna focus on two different ways of doing it. And they're fairly general ways, so they're applicable to a number of situations. And in addition, what I will do, I will point you to other sources in which you can look at different ways of doing this in the class notes. The problem of identifying relevant inputs for some software or some feature of it is called test data selection and can be expressed as follows. Let's consider our software. As usual, we have our input domain, which is the set of all the inputs for my software. And again, as usual, we have our output domain, which is the set of corresponding outputs for these inputs. So the question here is, how can we select a meaningful set of inputs in my domain? And of course, corresponding outputs, because we know that test cases are an input plus an expected output. So how can we select interesting inputs for our software? So a set of inputs that after we run them on the software, if the software behaves correctly, we'll have enough confidence that the software is correctly implemented. So one possible idea is, hey, why don't we just test them all? We just do exhaustive testing. We do all the inputs. Nowadays, we have powerful machines. We have a lot of computational power in the cloud. Why not just doing it? So to answer that question, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use another quiz.